Hi there! We're going to be seeing today in this video how to create this concrete wall effect. Let's see it. The first thing I would like to comment is that I created this effect entirely through the effects panel. The reason to do this is because if I want to save this as a style through the styles panel, just selecting it and adding style from selection, I'm gonna have the possibility of using and reusing this style as many times as I want. Another reason why I like using effects to create this is because if I now need to change my text, see, it adapts perfectly. This is the reasons why I would use effects and the style panels to do this. But honestly, if I was to make this only once, just to get it perfect and to make it just once, I wouldn't do it only through the effects panel. What I mean is that instead of using outer glows or inner glows, in some situations, I would just craft this myself with the geometry, subtracting and things like that, in order just to make it perfect. But this is good enough as to This is good enough as to show you a nice effect that I'm going now to walk you through so you can repeat it yourself. Okay, so let's see what I did. On top we have this is the last step actually. I just put this because otherwise it was a little bit too washed out. So I put this rectangle with some color on it, but that's the last step, as I say. Forget about it now. Now, the first thing I did is I went to Unsplash, which I do usually, and I just set a concrete wall texture, and I like this one, so I selected it, and then I came here, pasted it as a background. Okay, I'm gonna lock it so it doesn't move. Now, the texture I included in this text, I copy-pasted, overlapping exactly one on top of the other in such a way that this crack in here, it follows exactly and perfectly what I need. What I mean with this is that if I now take the text and move it up free like this, you see the crack is not following the texture, and that's not something that looks very realistic. So what you need to do is you need to move things together, okay? And you need to overlap them perfectly. I'm gonna lock this again, and now I'm going to show you what I did to create this texture. So the first thing would be choosing a robust font like this Arial Black. I write wall in there, and well, usually what I do is just to see something, because right now I see absolutely nothing. You just put some color, whatever, random. Now I want to show you how and why I use two pieces of text stacked. Well, as of today, Affinity Designer does not allow to stack the same effect for an object or for a piece of text. So what I needed to do in order to apply twice a shadow or twice an inner glow or whatever is stacking two pieces of text. It's not ideal, but it's what we have. So hopefully at some point they just think of this and make it as great as Adobe Fireworks was, because it was fantastic. It's stacking the same effect time and again. That was great. So what I had to do is just stack two pieces of the same text. So now we're going to analyze what we have in here. I click on effects and we see the first effect is going to be outer shadow. I'm going to uncheck it so you see what it's affecting. You could think, okay, this is a glow just by looking at it, but no, it's an outer shadow, because what I wanted here is to apply an angle, and the only effect that allows us to apply an angle is outer shadow. The glows do not have an angle possibility, so that's why I applied it, because I wanted it just to be on top of the letters. The only problem I have with this is that I would like it to, additionally to this wheel or knob or call it whatever, I would like it to be a fill input, to have a fill input too. Because sometimes it's just, for my wrist, for my hand, it's just too tiresome to use this thing and to get it exactly to the point I want. But this is a UI little problem, whatever. Now let's get to the point. If you want to replicate this effect, just pick the values from here, all of them, or whatever you consider works good for you, because what I do when I'm creating this is just go trying a little bit of this, a little bit of that, blah blah. I'm not gonna repeat it here now, other than just copying it and pasting it, because otherwise it's gonna be too long, this video. So let's just go through it and see each effect without making it overly long. So the next one, it's inner shadow. That one affects this area here, okay? So you see there, you see there? Okay, so these are the values, luminosity, opacity, blah, blah, blah. If anybody's asking or wondering, oh, then why this or not and not the other way, I don't know, I mean, I just go trying and whatever look like, this really works, I just leave. I never really know if it's gonna be a 37%, a 8 pixel or whatever, I just go trying, okay? So, this is for inner shadow. So, I already have it here because I clicked on this and copy attributes by Command C, Command Shift V. So I don't need to apply it now because we already have this, the whole of the text, except for the masking of the picture, we have it already here. So we're gonna keep going analyzing what we have in there, okay? The inner shadow we've seen, and the inner glow, which is this part in there you see now. And, well, these are the values, the parameters, okay? Now, the second piece of text has also an outer shadow that you're gonna see what it is. Outer shadow, I'm gonna take this up so you see it better. So this is the outer shadow. These are the values. This is an inner glow, you see it there. And this is an outer glow, okay? I put an overlay because it looks quite nice when it overlays the background image, so that's basically it. Now we close this, and the next thing we have to do is we select this text and we Command C, Command V, copy paste it. We take the one that is below, we Command C to copy attributes, we select the one below in our new text, and Command Shift V, we copy the attributes. Now what we have in here is the foundations for the whole text. And the only thing left to do is to include the texture. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to align this as it was the beginning. So we have it there. And now I come to the layers panel and I say, okay, this is my background image. Just remember to copy it and just don't move it around like this, okay? Just copy it and now mask it on the one that is on top, obviously, there. And just remember that we have this thing here that I put in order to make things a little bit more attractive. So I'm gonna pass it to the top and there you go. So just remember, you can store this in your styles panel, obviously this one and this one, both of them, because I'm using two different kind of styles. And remember also that you can, change it as you wish. Okay, that's the good thing about it. That was it for today. Thank you very much. Comment, like, kiss, love. Mwah. See you soon. Bye.